New Hartstone Grange. Although, I think there's a misprint at measure six, because there's a half mile on the line on four floorboards. I think that's a spot from the copy machine, so yeah. So it should be quarter, eight, quarter. So think more about the middle of the notes than about the beginning of the notes. All right. We'll start at the very end. So let's do like measure 29. Stay legato and try to show these dynamics.
So where's the peak of this passage?
At 34, B3 of 35.
Okay, sure, yeah. That works. Can you show that clearer, right? So like on this, and then you still have more to go, right? So show these dynamics. If it's just kind of beating time, it feels a little bit like what's the point. Okay, so make more of these dynamics here. Start at that last page, middle system, third bar, 4-4 bar, where it's like loud. So we have to feel this tempo steadily, but it doesn't necessarily mean that we have to show the steady tempo the whole time. So play the beginning. And I'll show every beat, but I'm not going to have an active pulsation on every beat. I'm in tempo, and I'm showing every beat, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. They're all there, but it's not like an active rebound from each beat, okay? It's called melding, where you're sort of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 is one way to do it. And another way is you just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. You show the beat smaller. Okay. Either way, you have to somehow bring out the preparation to the next more than the actual beat. Okay. It's an easy habit to get sucked into where it's just marking every beat. But you know. Who's next?
I'm also going to do Hark, Go Free.
I couldn't decide what to do at the end.
Yeah, I would say just hold it. Yeah, just hold it. It's good. What's your major again?
Choral.
Okay, cool. Great. It, to me, looks a little bit labored. Like the, and I see the legato, and it's great. One of the things that I struggle with in my conducting is how to show tension without being tense. You know? Because if I'm too tense, then I have a hard time controlling tempo. You know, it's all the stuff we work on last semester. So, how can you show that resistance, the apparent resistance, without just sort of tightening up, right? So try to sort of drop your shoulders, keep everything relaxed. And then a mental thing is, you are getting them to do something, so let them do it. You're not forcing them, right? We've been talking about it before, like, a horse jumping over the, I don't know, things horses jump over, whatever they're called. You don't do the jumping. You don't pull the horse. You just put the horse in position to do the jumping, right? So once you show that breath, then just listen for the sound you want, as opposed to really trying to, like, make them do every single note.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just start the beginning again. And then there's one specific about this one. Good. Yeah, that's already better. Can you try something? See, as this is an exercise, so I wouldn't conduct it this way. See how small you can conduct this and still get them to play. Find that same amount of focus. Bring them to that, to your hands, in the, with the same level of intensity. Yeah, that is, that's so much better.
My hands slipped.
So much better. Except for the echo. So much better.
It slipped.
Okay, now the last one. I love what you're going for at 14. I see what you're going for. I think maybe we need to just reframe it slightly. So tell me what you want at 14.
So I was trying to build into it, coming off of the whole note and the measure 13.
Yeah.
And then just kind of bring it from fortissimo a little bit downward and then gradually bring the whole phrase down once it gets to the next whole note.
I definitely saw that, the diminuendo. Tell me about the accents, though.
I didn't really do them.
Well, actually, I think you did, but what I saw was very percussive, and this is not, these are not percussive accents, right? So think of them as like longer and more legato accents.
So almost like a tenuto?
Yeah, definitely, yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep. That build, so like 10, 11, 12, measure 12. Yes, good. When you're showing those, right, that's exactly right. Listen for what you want more than you show what you want.
Yeah.
Okay, so put that your attention more towards hearing it than where you are hearing it. One more time. setup to me looks a little bit like you're kind of conducting like this and then just dropping the left hand. So it's still sort of out here. And if you're this far to one side, it looks kind of detached. You know what I mean? Sort of like, what's going on down there? So I think bring the downbeat a little more central and bring their attention right to the tip of the baton. Okay? Let's start it and then we'll do the end. Like I saw a couple little like pitches that
yeah,
sort of kept
I had
in.
A stumble,
oh, okay. That was you. That wasn't you. All right. I just didn't want to. I wanted to make sure there wasn't some other technical thing out. Do it one more time. Then. Very nice. Good. Now go to the end, and let's see if you can get that crescendo, subito pianissimo to happen more like what I think you